how they're kind of wilty and leathery, and you can see all the liquid at the bottom. So that's what you want, is you want them to sit for a little bit, get limp, so you actually can put them in a jar. And put some in a jar the day before yesterday, and you can see that they're totally submerged in liquid. You can see the bubbles.
So here we are a week later, and we have all of our spices that we're going to put into this pickle. And that is fenugreek, mustard seed, and some little Tabasco or Hawaiian chili peppers. And here's our ferment. It's got a lot of juice that's been drawn out of the... A lot of juice that's been drawn out of the mangoes. There's no water added to this. And the salt threw the liquid out. So we're just gonna drain this. I'm just going by feel here. We have about a gallon of mango pickle. A little over a gallon. And so I used maybe a quarter cup, maybe a third of a cup of seeds. And I'm just dry toasting them. There's no oil. Just gonna keep them moving. Okay, so now they're starting to pop. You can see them popping in the pan. If you want to zoom in there, they're starting to move around.
Yeah.
So we know they're pretty close. You might want to let them pop for a minute or two, and just keep moving them around. I've got quite a few in here. And you can smell them, smell delicious. You don't want to burn any of the spices. It tends to make them really bitter. Now this can go straight into my little molcajete. It's good to do spices one at a time, one type at a time, because they all toast at different rates. So that's pretty good. I'll put this in my bowl. I'll just put it back in here. I'm gonna mix in this big bowl here. All of it together. Oh shoot. I almost did the,
you
the
did,
bad thing.
You almost did what you were trying to avoid.
Yeah.
And that's what was the saying?
Don't burn the fenugreek. I just caught this in the nick of time. And it's just gold and brown.
Nice.
Yeah, that golden color. So I'm just gonna... Much easier to grind this now. Got a little too much in this grinder for fenugreek.
Because you could use a coffee grinder, spice grinder, if you're too lazy to do this.
Yeah, if you don't have one of these, or if you're too weak and old. I don't know, they're not grinding that well.
Oh.
They smell good. So maybe we'll have to bust out the grinder on those. But now, I wanted to fry these chilies. Throw that in there, and you can just turn it off. Okay, so here we are grinding the...
Because somebody's too weak and old. How old are you?
This into the big bowl. Jars. So we're going to add our ground up mustard seeds, our fenugreek, and then what I wanted to do was just kind of dilute this oil with more oil, kind of get that chili flavor all the way through it. And then just kind of pour some of that on there. And then I'll top it off with the oil at the end. Okay, so I'm just gonna mix this up, basically, and then it's done, and then you just stick it in the jars and top it off with the oil. That's pretty much how it... There it is. Oil right there. This will be fine in the fridge, even if it's not covered with oil. So, that's what you want. Stick the lid on, stick it in the fridge. Take a couple of years to eat it. So here you have the finished product. Yeah.
So good.
So good. And this has actually been sitting out for probably, what has it been, like almost 3 weeks now. I had it in the fridge. And you can see the level of the oil rose up to the top. It actually was coming out of the jar. And that's just all the ferment action that's going on is pushing all the liquids up. And so now you have this nice layer of oil on top, which keeps any mold from growing. And you can see at the bottom where there's a little bit of liquid, actual water. I mean, non-oily substance, there it is right there. And then you see the oil floats on top of that and keeps it all good. So we tried these pickles and they were, according to everyone involved, they were too salty. But this obviously keeps in like a very tropical climate, so that's good. So we thought, big chunks like this, you don't really want to eat, you know, it's just too salty. So we're just going to put them in the food processor, make them into like a little, like a chutney almost, and just little bits, and then just kind of use them as a condiment on food. And we've been trying it, just chopping up little bits, and it's pretty good. It's pretty excellent. All right. Yeah.